Welcome to today's YouTube video. Today I will be giving you some information on what shows are the best shows to go to around the world. It's a question we've been asked by some of our viewers. We've also been asked more on questions about postage, which I shall answer. I want to show you an Afrika Korps cap, which I've recently purchased, and also some of the purchases we've made at the Michael Baldwin auction. Exciting news about the Michael Baldwin collection, and also we'll be revealing the winner of last week's prize, which was the book Felzug 1915. So I shall start with talking about the Michael Baldwin auction. I've not been in the office for a couple of days because I was at the auction. We have purchased some really nice things. A mint 1917 helmet in mint condition, a pair of early 1910 trousers, a Prussian tin pickle, really, really nice condition, a Bavarian M15 pickle, a nice bayonet, a Saxon Feldmutz, a mint condition Prussian belt, which is featured in one of the books, and some other small bits. So we've bought a few bits, which will all be coming onto our website in the next few weeks. Most exciting news for us about the Michael Baldwin collection is that the estate have asked us to sell the remains of his collection, so there'll be lots of shoulder boards and a few items, some headdress that have come from the Michael Baldwin collection, and we will be listing them on our website for sale on behalf of the family. So that will all happen in the next few weeks. There will not be an update this Friday because of the auction and various commitments we have. We haven't had time to do an update for this Friday, so our next update will be next Friday. So I wanted to talk about shows. We were asked a question of what are the best shows to go to. There's lots of shows. There's usually a show on every weekend in the UK. My favourite shows, which I would strongly recommend to go to in England, are the War and Peace show, which is in Kent. That always happens towards the end of July. It's an outdoor show. There's lots of reenactors, lots of vehicles, and there's quite a few, you know, stallholders of Militaria. That's always a good show to go to, and it happens over a space of a week. So, you know, you can pick your day on which you wish to go. It's at the Hop Farm in Paddockwood in Kent. Another show which we like in the UK, and it's actually on this weekend, is the Birmingham International. It's held at the Motorcycle Museum in Birmingham, right next door to the NEC. It's a one-day show, always on a Sunday, and that is this weekend, the 11th of November. We will be there, so if you want to see anything at the show, just contact us and we can bring it along. I think it opens to the public at about 8:30 in the morning. As far as overseas shows, we do shows in Germany. We do Cine in Belgium, which is a good show, very big. You saw that in one of my previous videos. And also the best show that I go to is in Louisville, Kentucky, the SOS show. It's called the Show of Shows. And that always happens in February, March time every year. That's probably the biggest best show we go to. So there's a few shows that I would strongly recommend if you want to go along and actually see and hold some of the stuff. Last week was really exciting. A friend of mine managed to pick up a really, really nice Afrika Korps cap. Now, as many of you know, I used to collect Afrika Korps items. I'm still really passionately interested in them. I'm planning on doing a new book on Afrika Korps and tropical items. So I was really excited when he turned up with this lovely Afrika Korps cap. So the Afrika Korps soldier used to like their uniform to be as bleached as possible, as white as possible. They were issued in olive drab or a green colour, and quite often the sun would bleach their clothing. Because the soldier wanted to look like he was a veteran, they used to purposely chemically bleach their uniforms as well, mostly their tunics and caps. And when they chemically bleached them, they would come out in this very white, white colour. Some materials bleached quicker than others. And quite often when you look behind the, you know, in the seams of the material, you can see the original colour of the cap in the material. So this cap came to me last week. It's really, really rare. It has a white soutache, which is very unusual. Most of the caps you see from Africa are Panzer or Panzer Grenadier, so they'd be pink or green soutache. This one has a white soutache, which means it was part of the rare regiment called the Army Flak Regiment. They were like Luftwaffe Flak, but they were part of the army. So they were the only regiment in Africa to wear the white soutache. People often think or assume that white soutache is infantry, which is the case in the European theatre, but in Africa it was a specialised unit called the Army Flak Regiment. As you can see, it's very, very bleached. It's got all the original insignia on it. A few nice features, like a small repair here made from like a silky material. The silky material is also being used as a trim on the edge of the cap around the back, and to make the cap bigger at the back, a form of elastic has been applied as well, so the cap can fit on his head. Quite often that happens because caps were reissued. They would pick up a cap from a pile that were left behind, and they would have to adapt it to fit their head. Inside the cap, it has the typical red lining that you are familiar with Afrika Korps caps. The maker's stamp is completely washed out, it's completely faded away, but I can tell from my experience that this cap is made by Robert Lubstein, probably 1941. So, you know, this cap has basically come from a veteran. It's really, really exciting to have it. I think I might have sold it already. I'm in negotiations with someone, but a really super piece that I wanted to show you.
I've had a few more questions about postage. One of the popular questions I keep getting is, where do we ship to? Well, the answer is we ship all over the world. We'll ship to America, all over Scandinavia, Russia. We ship absolutely everywhere. So don't be frightened to order if you're watching it from a country far away. We have a very, very good success rate, and we've been shipping items for the last 40 years. So there should never be a problem, no matter where you are in the world. And lastly, wanted to announce the winner of the last week's giveaway. So the book we were giving away was Feldzug 1915 by Michael Baldwin. I published the book. There's a whole series, 1914 right through to 1918, and this week's winner was David Williams. I don't have your contact details, so if you're watching the video, please get in touch by emailing me. My email address is daniel@regimentals.co.uk, and we will get this shipped out to you straight away. So just a reminder, no update this week, but nevertheless, please go onto our website, www.regimentals.co.uk, and our next update will be next Friday. So keep following us on YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter.